Welcome everyone to the Co-op Walkthrough Series, episode 107.
We're still in this area.
Let's get out of it. That's the goal. Let's get the heck out.
Need to open one door.
Ah, made of flower delicious.
Petals. We just had to collect some food, by the way, too.
Ah, the ritual comes back to me. If you sprinkle some of the extra potash on it and move your petals' fingers like so and water it and sway with the sun. No, yes, yes, you've got it. Tell Lady Zen Zen 7 Star.
I feel like you just described a voodoo ritual that we have to now perform.
Yashche remembered the ritual? Of course.
It.
Now we have to first get to the petal door. Fly up Dwell to
Elto. Oh my gosh,
we're
out of here.
Meet you there.
I'll fly up there.
Excuse me. Wasn't born to follow.
What are you doing?
That's literally the name of the quest. Wasn't born to follow. That's the name of the quest. But yet we're following her up.
Yet we're flying.
Yeah. So she's contradicting herself. Oh, there she is.
It's impossible to believe that King Neza is gone. But I have to take on my duties at once. One of the first things I must do is clean up the chaos caused by the Shadow Queen, and this will help you at the same time. The way to the petal door is still blocked by the Shadow Queen's web barrier.
Stop.
You need some spider essence
to tear it down.
You can get the spider essence by defeating the Starfall spiders that have nested at the top of the Zalotl Tower.
Get some mark here.
Yeah, please leave that mark. The who now, spiders?
Oh, this is always a risky. Oh, gosh.
I'm proud.
Where are you? Did you already get there?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
My Papadilla Pepper, the parrot. Oh, it's an instance. Okay, I'm here.
What? Oh, it's up here.
I mean, we are actually really high up. Ears are starting to pop.
Maybe with 3 seconds.
I believed in you. Who dis? I don't understand why they're like in their own secluded, but then again, it is Azteca, and I
was like thinking, I'm like, where are there spider mobs in this area?
I'm confused.
Yeah.
That's Azteca's job, is to be confusing.
Mm. I mean, you have to
turn up the drums
a lot. That's all we got to live for is the drums.
That's what's keeping me motivated
at this point.
Yeah, there's nothing else other than the fact that the drums are keeping my spirit alive.
No, when we get to Christmas and we're like, you know, 20 eps in, and we're still going.
People, I mean, I might even fake my own death mid walk for that one.
Get out of that one.
I'm not even kidding you. I'll be gone. Be like, yeah, well, team, we got this far. That's terrible.
Let's just take a hiatus and see you in 6 months.
You know.
We literally say at the end, all right, guys, see you in 6 months.
Yeah, whoa.
We come back on the dot. Act like nothing happened.
I feel like we did that with a similar series.
Oh, that happened with Pirate. It wasn't 100% planned, but it just kind of happened.
Yeah, I mean, but that's just the way it is. I mean, no, but, are we good? Yeah, we're good to hit now. All right.
No.
No, we'll continue, team. I'm just being cheeky. Because I'm half asleep right now.
Well, yeah, I mean, almost done with Azteca, and then Chris, this is a big struggle, and then Polaris is cakewalk.
I think the biggest guarantee I can make for everybody, because there's always a few comments in between, is that I guarantee you we will be done before Mirage. Blue quote 2016.
Yeah.
Okay, you let me off that mark, right?
Maybe.
All right. 6 on 1. 7.
Okay, here's your essence.
Well done!
Hopefully it's good
enough. A small bit of the shadow expunged. Take the spider essence and use it to tear down the web barrier.
It's not 90, but it's close.
Okay.
Much better. Thank you for your help, magician. I will do what I can to honor my grandfather's memory and rule well. Our ways part here. You'll find your ally, Onyx Rainsun, by the pedal door. She must be the one to introduce you to the Jaguar lands. Fly true.
Okay, almost there.
I can't
Magician,
say I'm sad.
I understand it is time for you to see the floating mountains. Use the ritual Yashche taught you to activate the petal door. It will take you to the floating mountains.
Yeah.
The Oracle lives there. We need her to guide us to the Pyramid of the Falling Star, the last of the great step pyramids. Beyond the petal door, you will find Okuhaje Mirror Knife, the guardian of the Oracle.
You need
to win him over before you can see her.
The knife.
Can we perform this ritual already?
You perform the ritual that Yashche taught you. With petal finger gestures, some potash, and some good old-fashioned watering. A moment later, the flowers all bloom brightly with a magical glow.
Didn't have to hit X.
Thank the gods. Here well, we made it, team. The floating mountains.
Yeah, a lot of bosses around here.
It's actually a beautiful area.
Ilhuya, you have earned your way with difficulty and suffering. You have been sent to consult with the Oracle to find the Pyramid of the Falling Star.
Right.
You are not the only one searching for the Oracle. There are obstacles to overcome in this journey. Your first is Isla Tormenta. The island was conquered by a Chronosaur, who kidnapped the Storm Quetzals. He cages their power for himself. Defeat Ahuizotl Drowned Dog. Free the Storm Quetzals he captured. And coax them back to the Storm Pillars. They will recharge the Storm Pillars, which will summon a prismatic blade. Take it, for you will need it later.
Hope you got all that and wrote it down.
Yeah, I have a notepad up.
Took down the info. Oh yeah, the raining.
Beautiful music though.
The raining area, the hot tub.
Never forget the. I don't know if I can. Oh my gosh, he just walked straight
you
up.
Can scale this, the wall.
The forgotten pools. This is probably.
Forgotten tub.
Yeah, that is the. It's one of the top cleansing sites. I think I added that to my top 10 water features video. That was some
nice
to go.
Pond.
Wow. It is.
Yeah,
not many that. I mean, hopefully people know about it. If this isn't a sewer Azteca style.
And then it drains into this. Is.
Yeah.
Pirate 101.
Exactly.
Even Squaw Island. It's always in Squaw Island.
Okay.
The sewers are.
Again. Right.
Okay.
Your eyes and teeth are so pretty. Do you mind if I keep them?
That's a problem. I mean, right off the bat, I mean, you were talking about before we were even recording, a lot of bosses coming up.
Yeah, that's basically what this area is.
Definitely a shift, though, from the, personally unnecessary quests that were kind of holding us back in the, I have a cleanse. Yeah, the Cloudburst, even though it's a beautiful area, in Alto Alto-ish. More so Cloudburst.
Yeah, that's not just, like, a straight shot through
Cloudburst
and Alto Alto. Yeah, you go back and do a lot of stuff to get through those.
Probably catches a lot of people off guard.
But from now on, I think, unless there's like a few here and there, it's mostly just floating mountains.
Twin giants.
One thing, go back. Shaboo.
Yeah, right.
That's what I remember. So.
Same.
Okay.
I think that's kind of a current mood thing.
At least it's on you.
Right.
At least he crit.
Here we go.
2K.
Not even. Doubt my power.
I actually thought that was going to be a lot more than only 900.
Well, you thought.
You thought wrong.
You did. Gotta trust.
Well, you have the most storm resist probably, though.
I do.
Yeah.
Always trust Blue. When he's on his ice.
Goodness.
If I could find the Think that'd be great. Appreciate ya. I do have that cleanse. But yeah, I wouldn't hit though because actually no, you have that new spell, don't you? Well, you probably
no.
Whatever you use.
The new spell is 10 pips.
That's right.
It's not easy to use it.
No, it's not.
Plus if I use it, like, yeah, I guarantee it kills the boss, but it might not kill the
I can always
5K health guy.
Whatever floats your mountain.
So, yeah, I'll just do this.
What we got?
Yeah.
Right.
What we got?
Oh my gosh. I forgot. Yeah, the minus four. You know what, Nate, though? I think that's a sign
that... I thought this was a cleanse.
I thought it was, too. But it's one of those things where it's a life lesson, really. Other than the fact that... See, I guess you can't trust Blue after all. Illuminati.
Even on his eyes.
See?
Oh.
And I told you, we're good. Chill.
You told me I was gonna crit?
I was hoping for it. Ooh.
Yes.
Alright. We got away easy. Still has like 5,000.
Still alive.
Still, well, fair amount. And he didn't block it, so that's actually. Well, he had Fortify as well.
Oh, yeah.
He's dead.
500, yeah. Bye.
Oh, yeah. Rest in peace. To be honest, I thought he had 28,000, not 23,000. I gave him way too much credit. Rest in pasta. What?
I guess he's a dog. Oh yeah, he's a dog-drawn dog. Makes sense. It's kind of sad if dog-drawn, though. I cannot click this.
I hope you can. I wish luck.
I wish you luck.
Good. Luck.
Yeah, I'll let you know when I can click
with the
it.
Monster
right.
defeated,
I'll make it my way back to wherever we need
race
to be.
Out to the open air,
once again, another ritual. This episode is full of rituals.
Important.
Good.
You gently coo at the storm kettles.
Whoa!
As they fly and brush up against you, you feel a static charge. Suddenly, one emits a small roar, and sparks fly from it to the pillar. All three pillars burst into electric light.
That's my kind of voodoo.
A shimmering prismatic blade appears on the dais.
Did you steal my blade?
Yep.
Oh, there's another one.
They lied. There's only one.
Only one.
Nobody can keep the truth this episode.
The true wizard can wield the
blade. Alright, I had a mark back here. That's awkward.
So did I, but I'm gonna take the scenic route.
We leveled, Nate.
You prove you have some small ability. Before I allow you to ask the Oracle how to find the Pyramid of the Falling Star, you must obtain a suitable offering. Magwe Century Cat can fashion you a new day charm. If you ask him nicely, he lives on Isla del Fuego, but the bridge is out. To reach Del Fuego, find the bridge post at the edge of Isla Tormenta. Create a burning bridge with the prismatic blade. Find Magway's Century
I always
Cat
forget
and ask him to craft a gift for the Oracle.
We do to summon the bridge, and every time I'm reminded that, we actually just, like, slap a, like, a magical sword.
Yeah, that's kind of like a magic guts. Wand.
Pretty cool.
Slash blade.
Right.
But...
it's actually my favorite island. Mountain, I guess.
Wait, so... oh,
man. You slice the prismatic blade through the bridge posts and feel a surge of
magic. How do
our
feet not get toasted? I don't know.
The flame rushes down to form a bridge. You hope it will hold you.
So up in the top right, is that the Twin Giants? Yeah.
You don't
Excuse
see any
me?
Jaguars here,
look up,
and there are indications of violence around the
look
tent.
Up to the top right.
Not a good sign. You should tell Okahaja Min.
Yeah, so we can see Twin Giants.
Oh, yeah, those are it. Okay, I think so. Oh, excuse me. Oh, you have that port?
Yeah.
I'll leave mine by him.
That is troubling news. It is as if the forces of the Shadow Queen are here already, attacking us where we least expect.
That is rather a lot to suppose, isn't it? It's as if Okuhaja has some secret knowledge. You better keep your eyes open.
We must find Magway Century Cat, or else there
He's
will be
lying
no
to?
Way to appease the Oracle. Or appease the Shadow Queen.
No, I did not just say appease the Shadow Queen. Why would you ask that? Are you challenging me?
Let's fight him.
Good. Go back to Isla del Fuego and search high and low for Magwe.
Knock him off the island.
Could you imagine?
Okay.
One of those things, I think we talked about that in the pirate walk. If you just all of a sudden just like all of a sudden combusted and like the ship just blew up and you were flying, where would you go?
I mean, that's what happens. If you die in the combat on the Skyway, it just teleports you to a life fountain, so I guess you kind of can.
That's true.
But I don't know.
We're always talking theoreticals here.
I think someone in the comments said like you would fall and you'd end up in Wiz or something.
I believe it.
The signs of scuffle lead you to this cave. Always a cave. Never someplace nice.
Yeah, that is true. Or Wizards more caves. Pirates more sewers.
Yeah, I respect that. Caves of Wiz or pirate sewers.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about 1,000 degrees or more.
Fire.
I dare you to touch that lava.
It's a weird color.
I will blacken the air with 100 smoking arrows to lance your flesh.
You're gonna die before that happens.
Where are you gonna get the arrows?
Yeah. Thinks he's good.
I'll just use this now.
Invest the pips.
It's needed.
I mean, we're already on the second mountain.
Yeah, almost done.
I mean, really?
Better.
Did you just say better? As in, like, you're better than
as
me?
As in, I'm better at blocking.
Because you blocked? That's funny.
I saw some of his arrows in the back.
Maybe those are the ones he's talking about. They have to be. I do have the cleanse, but it's on me. I'm sweating.
Yeah, it's pretty hot in this room.
We're in a volcano, mate.
It's more than a room.
It's more than a room. Like, this is a volcano. Not the most ideal place. I really don't know how these birds are even existing in here. Okay.
I mean, it's kind of my natural habitat, so.
I don't think so, though, but.
I don't think you want to live here.
I'll accept that. Maybe Thalmia. Maybe not even her, though. Because all that hairspray holding up her hair just bursts into flames.
Probably does when she gets mad.
She gets angry. That's something cool, though, that, you know, I've often thought about, though, too, Nate, where it'd be very cool if they did a kind of makeover, if you will, of all of, like, Wizard City, including, like, models, and just, like, eventually make their way for, like, major characters of the schools. You know what I mean? That'd be cool. And then, like, for example, having Thalmia have, like, fiery hair. You know what I mean? Kind of like those, like, flashy looks.
Nah, we just need, like, a opposite Ravenwood. That's everyone's. It's opposite everyone, so everyone in Ravenwood would be bad except Cyrus.
In all honesty, I'm completely for that, but I'm also for a Thalmia makeover. I agree on both.
I mean, is Cyrus all bad though? No, but.
I'm waiting for a Cyrus betrayal.
Or maybe he just acts like that. He's actually.
It's just like that.
Understand. Ambrose is like.
The Shadow Queen did not tell me you were so strong. Almost as if she meant for me to lose.
Who dis?
Of course. I'll just stare at him.
I was gonna say his little feet, but I just realized his feet are inside of the cage.
Ears became happy when you kicked his tail feathers.
While you make acquaintances with the Mercury cat, I'll be heading out.
Please, magician,
his eyes are happy.
Meet me outside.
I mean, did you see how small his legs are?
They're inside the floor.
I beg to differ.
That vile pigeon Hozenek demanded an offering for the Shadow Queen to give to the Oracle. I would do no such thing. But for you, noble magician, I would be honored. Let me craft a new day charm for you. The Oracle needs this to be able to read your destiny. Here, breathe onto the charm to enchant it. Well done. Here, take this new day charm to give to the Oracle. Make sure it doesn't fall into the wrong hands.
You found Magway Century Cat? Did you get an offering from him? Quick, let me see it. Yes, this new day charm is the perfect offering for the Oracle. She will be able to read your destiny with
Whoa!
It. I should give it back to you. If only I could.
Like, under some kind of spell.
Once again, wizard, what was briefly yours is now mine. I'll take that new day charm for Morgant. Okohachi, kill the wizard. How odd that it should end this way for us after so many stimulating encounters. I almost regret it.
The only way you get to the Oracle is by defeating me. Enter the Apocalypto Cave and prepare yourself for battle.
It's like he doesn't even want to fight us.
No, I think he was a good cat, literally.
Literally.
He was under some type of enchantress spell.
Voodoo.
Magician, I cannot break the Shadow's enthrallment, but I do regret what is about to occur.
Make sure you remove them prisms.
So he assumed he's gonna smash us.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but this is the exact same style of grass in the same like style of area as is the broodmother in Chrysalis.
I see what you're getting at. Maybe.
Don't argue me on this.
There's more flowers with
right.
The broodmother.
Right. They're definitely a more beautiful place. This will have to do for now.
Yeah, at least there's grass.
What could he possibly use?
Yeah.
Well, he's saving up.
AKA Savage Paw.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Belloc really did scare me, though. I always forget that.
Yeah, I didn't know he could teleport.
Straight up teleportation. When did he acquire that skill? Post-Safaria? Must have been a deal with Morgant. Sell me your soul and I'll allow you to travel through time.
Yeah.
Like, okay. Thanks.
Like, thanks, Morg.
And then just completely entitled and indebted for, well, you're ever.
I mean, yeah, you gave up your soul. Like, better enjoy that teleportation.
Make use of it as much as you can.
That's the way he just popped in there because he's gotta make use.
Gotta make use. There's no other explanation. Stop.
How many pips are these?
A lot. Oh. Maybe.
Is it like four? What?
Six.
That spell's pretty good.
Time to blade ya. It is really good, actually.
power.
I'm gonna have to really blade you up.
We got a lot of time.
We do.
I'll use dragon next. Oh, I can have another blade.
I didn't realize how low you are in health.
Yeah, I got slapped.
You won't die. Fortify, thank you.
Alright.
You got everything I can essentially give you.
This is so many blades. And the aura, triple thing.
Yeah, you gotta power through the, Yeah, never mind, I was gonna say shield, but...
Doesn't even matter. Another tower.
I would heal you if I got a new pip. Just remember to heal up.
Four, five, six, seven. Pretty good. Through tower.
Ah, Belloc, you wretch! Magician, you have broken my cruel enthrallment to Belloc and the Shadow Queen. I do not know if I can be forgiven for betraying the Oracle, but I will do my best.
I don't forgive you.
Let us speak outside.
I don't forgive him either. He made me lose a bunch of pips.
He made me waste TC on him.
Yeah, can't forgive that.
Nope. One of the few things in the spiral I'll never forgive.
That's a long voyage.
I can finally think!
My mind is truly clear again. With the new day charm, Belloc and the Shadow Queen can force the Oracle to help them. You must help her! I cannot undo the damage I've done, but let me do what I can. Go to my tent. Outside, you'll find a skyhook. Take it. The skyhook will let you travel up and down the magical zip lines. Use it to sail across the sky to the Isla Mayor, where you will find the Oracle's home. Find her and help her against the Shadow.
Excuse me?
Is this Oracle a real person? Give me the hook.
You find the sky hook and take it. This relic will allow you to navigate the zip lines of the floating mountains.
I'm just looking for a wisp.
Here we go.
Again, there are signs of a scuffle. Morgant's forces cannot help but leave a trail of destruction. You think you hear sounds of conflict, but the Pampero spirits are making a tremendous racket.
Five.
Maybe if you quell a few.
All right, we got them defeated.
Into the next cave.
Yeah, they were like, oh, help, or something like that. So another
cry for help from the cave.
Yeah, another cave. Common theme.
Your persistence surprises even me, but I cannot let you detain me. The Oracle revealed that I need this crystal skull to find the Horn of Hurakan. So I'll just take the crystal skull and leave you two steps behind, as always. Nakir, deal with the wizard.
I'll crack your bones and slake my thirst and earn a great commendation from the Shadow Queen.
That's disgusting. Lou talks about cracking our bones and like completely
eating,
like,
them, eating the bone marrow.
Eating us and then like, no, stop.
That's what he wants to do.
Like, stop.
What if that's his ambition?
Seems to be. That's what he was born to do.
He's a bug.
I'll never understand, like, all these Grizzleheim-like voodoo symbols that are always behind walls of these bug'em good people. That's the one thing, like, the lore behind these guys.
Is there lore behind the symbols?
I mean, probably not, but if there is, I would want to know. And I don't know. But it reminds me so much of Grizzleheim. And, like, you know, were they a
subclass? There's a lot of rune symbol things, yeah.
Yeah, are they, like, a species that originally from, like, maybe a distant world? Or, like, I need some details, K.I.
Cave paintings.
Or they could just be just...
I mean, that's the whole...
There, yeah.
The whole setup of...
I think it's a territory thing.
This arc is cave paintings from Savaria.
That's true.
It's possible.
Oh yeah, that's right. Wow.
Yeah.
Polaris roots. Crazy.
Go back to see the paintings and...
I'm sure there's some hidden messages in this game that have still not been found. More likely no, but I hope.
Like, yeah. They threw enough hints in there, but I mean, I wouldn't say any of them are super vague.
Right. As of late, there aren't really any real good juicy hints in the game that were laid out.
They kind of just throw names out there of different worlds that we might go to eventually.
Well, yeah, I mean, like, the more recent, especially with the Wallaroo getup that we visited with the Brandon, the Make-A-Wish quest. Hype for the Dragonspire, especially when that comes out to Live Realm. But you know, those little things, they I always get butterflies and stuff like that. It's just like Wallaroo. So then I Google what Wallaroo is, and it's like, I don't remember exactly, but I'm pretty sure something to do with like walruses. I don't know.
Makes sense.
But then again, we just came from Polaris, which two cold worlds? I don't think so.
Wow.
I don't know about that either, but that's something I'm confused about.
The one time I want to use that spell and it fizzles, like,
I was proud of you too, but I didn't say anything when you use it. I'm like, yes, he's using it. But the thing is that I don't think the arc in my eyes will be successful if they do two cold worlds. It just doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
It's like saying you're having two Celestias in an arc, like two underwater worlds. That doesn't flow. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that wouldn't make sense. It's good.
Yeah, whatever works. Next. I mean, they kind of just probably threw that out there just for some point. Maybe we'll go there.
Maybe.
I knew you would come for me. Please.
I was going to say, who's talking outside.
To me? I don't know who it was. The person crying for help.
Oh yeah, the person
inside the bug.
Yeah, that's true.
In the bug costume.
Kind of voodoo.
I am hurt. The Shadows agent Belloc tricked me by giving me the New Day amulet. I thought he was you. The Shadow Queen has not yet found the Horn of Hurricane, but the crystal skull that Belloc stole will help her find it. Before I can say more, you must ask Quix Saltwater in Salt Meadow Swamp for healing clay for a poultice, else I will not
leave. Salt Meadow Swamp. I'm leaving a mark.
That's the biggest mark I'm leaving right
there. There is no way we're going back to this swamp.
I guess.
Although we are. Talk about delaying the inevitable. Wow.
Can I use this? No, I have to wait for like another delay. Why are there so many delays and stuff? I'm just pouring to you.
Trust me, I'm not even there yet. I'm like, where the heck?
What's your name? Get some wisp while I wait. Oh, wow. That was a little close. We've already fought these guys enough.
The only high priest in the entire land.
Yeah. Magician. I did not expect to see your like again. You need healing clay to treat the Oracle's wounds? You can get the healing clay from the river cave, but a minion of the Shadow Queen lurks there. Ekra Bleeding Rose. Get the clay
this
and make
cave
the Oracle.
That was unlit the entire time, and now we're going inside.
Oh, probably a side quest. Nope.
You would think. I'm disappointed in you, Saltwater.
Once you get to the Floating Mountains, then you come back.
Absolutely
embarrassed. A rose by any other name would tear you to pieces by thorn and hook.
Charge!
I don't think that's how the one-liner went.
I know. 17,000. What a joke. Gets his, like, 2 minutes of fame.
They all got something to say.
They do. Excuse me!
What a great spell.
It's one of the best. Never disappoints. Like, I don't even know what spells I'm clicking, but it's just like muscle memory where it's just, this makes sense.
See, faint? Use faint. All you need to do.
Well, it just goes so much smoother. Excuse me. I never know why I do that, but it's called upon me. Imagine if that was the hoof of Wu instead of a giant hand. Imagine if that was the case.
That'd be the best spell ever.
I would make a life just to cast that spell every time I could. You know that's a good idea. Oh, I better have TC Faint still.
If you have TC Faint, I'm gonna hit. You know, and I could totally see it too. I can just see
it. And then you see a little bit of like the bottom of her dress, and then like her, the
like through the clouds.
Yeah. But it's just like her hoof, like she's. Oh my gosh! For some reason I feel like I need to Photoshop that. I better get on that before people actually watch the video and make it for me. I don't know how I'm gonna do that though. I mean, you really have to zoom into her hoof.
Go to life school and zoom in and take a pic.
And you have to blow it up. I don't know. That's difficult. Maybe it's better to think of it as a theoretical than an actual thing.
1600.
Yeah, I guess I ran out of regular faints. I was discarding. He'll be dead next.
Is this guy dead?
Yeah.
There it is.
I'm gonna look into that tonight, though. I'm actually really excited. I'm gonna see if I can do it.
I fizzled like 3 times this episode.
How much health has he got? Another month.
Unreal amount of times I fizzled.
Yeah, I don't think you fizzled this much in the entire world.
Not since Wizard City.
Nope.
200. The one meteor.
Good!
Yeah, but I don't have it, though. Oh, why did I draw that? Never ending boss fight.
What is going on?
There it is. Fizzle again.
You know how low probability that would have been.
10% twice. It's pretty bad.
So 20 out of 180, which is what probability? Let's do the math right now.
I mean, oh, my fizzle's not that high yet.
Calculator on the old phone. That is a...
Still fizzle.
When Ekra scampers away, you help yourself to the healing clay you'll need.
And we're going back.
All of that.
Ah, the poultice you made is most soothing. Thank you. I feel better already. The Pyramid of the Falling Star is located on the highest floating island, known as the Twin Giants. Hurry, and use the zipline to catch Belloc.
That's all
we need
to know.
You can tell the zipline has been smashed to pieces. A shame the Oracle couldn't have predicted this.
She couldn't have looked over.
What? That's terrible. Without my crystal skull, I can no longer see what is to come.
So she's alive, another way, too.
But you'll have to beg the assistance of Guaman Skyfall, a proud and haughty avian. Go to the peaks of Isla Nevadas and find Guaman Skyfall at the temple called Seven Stabs of the Knife.
Whoa.
Seven Stabs of the Knife? Goodness me!
It's the best name
ever.
Talk
about a, if I can use the actual zipline for the clothes.
I feel like everything has to reset that we're using around here. It's weird.
Seven Stabs of the Knife. What are you? I cannot stand the Stegosaurus, nor do I have time for jaguars. Who sent you? The Oracle? She is nothing to me. But I will make you a deal. If you defeat me in a duel, I will help you reach the Twin Giants. If you fail, I'll take your mana.
No problem. I got a setup.
Yeah, you can have it. I got a potion.
I got some potions, and I got a setup with the potion lady back in Wizard. Thinking he good.
Not a bad deal.
Exactly. Take all the mana you want, dumb bird. His name is definitely more scary than this guy.
What about this?
Well, this is scary too.
Eh.
Not as good as I remember. Then again, we were terrible back then.
This should be the last boss of Floating Mountains.
Yeah, and then, I mean, team, all next step will be journeying throughout the Twin Giants and then Tartarus and Shibubu and then the true Chrysalis journey. Wow. That is going to be an adventure, to say the least. And I also have to restock TC Faint for next time. I gotta remember that.
Yeah.
I have absolutely none in my side deck, which is unfortunate, but I will blade you again. And
well, a lot of bosses today.
It was.
It's basically what Floating Mountains is.
It is.
Ooh. Well, here we go.
Yeah. Should be sufficient.
Hmm?
I blame the Fortify. I'll feign him up again, though.
How much health does he have? 5,000, yeah. Swap him in more bleeds.
Fair amount.
Yeah, that was good. Should be able to. Yeah.
Not a bad area.
Yeah, it wasn't too much of a struggle, to be honest. Twin Giants is more difficult.
Yeah, a little bit. The Belloc. The Ascent. The classical.
I am suitably impressed. Meet me outside the temple and we will talk.
Okay. Let's talk to him and make our actual way to the get-ems. Where's he at?
Oh, he's on the other side. Pick you out.
Why do you need to reach the twin giants? Ah, you seek to stop the shadow? Good luck with that. Go up to Noble Rock. You'll recognize it when you see it. Let me teach you the transformation words. Tekua Rakepe. It means the one who comes flying from the islands of light like an eagle of fire. Appropriate, no? Meditate at Noble
Rock. I'm good
at
meditating.
By chanting the words of transformation.
Become
then
an eagle.
Soar to the twin giants. Look for Kwikani Thundersong.
Yeah.
Let's use the rock and make our way.
You literally have to transform in order to fly to the twin giants.
Oh, never mind.
You close your eyes and meditate on the form of Noble Rock. You try hard to repeat what Guaman taught you. Tekawa La Kepe.
Oh, there's the twin giants.
But you keep saying time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping into the future. apparently that was good enough.
Yep.
Stuck in our
head,
I guess.
Well, we made it, team. We made it to the twin giants, the final area of Azteca. Very, very important dungeons coming up. Shabalba, Tartarus.
Oh, yeah.
Belloc. A lot goes on in these next 90. Few apps.
Yeah, we're probably going to hit 90 before we finish. Well, at least by the end of Twin Giants.
Oh, yeah, definitely. So, but if you've stuck all the way through this long app, we got a lot accomplished today. Please leave a like. It's always appreciated. Subscribe if you haven't already. Stay updated with more Wiz videos. Other than that, team, take care. We'll see you all next time.